It's Steven here, and we're back at it again with an SGC reveal. First, we're going to go over what was sent into us, and then we're going to go over the cards that are going in our inventory, as well as Ryan's cards that he's going to keep for his PC. Stay tuned. Starting out with our customers' cards, we only had 7 sent in from customers, and the other 59 are ours, making a total of around 66 cards. Let's get into it. First off here, we have a Walter Payton rookie, 3.5. We have a Ted Williams, SGC 2, off center here, but as you can see, even with not the best centering, SGC will still give cards like this a 2. 67 tops, Hank Aaron. 67 tops, Clemente. 58 tops, Willie Mays. 56 tops, Eddie Matthews. And the last card that was subbed with us, Orlando Cespeda rookie, 1958 tops and an SGC 4. Alrighty, we saw all this, and now let's move on to our cards. We're going to start our cards off with the Sebastian Bach Liebig 1893. Very detailed and nice card. Continuing on here, we have another Liebig. This one, Richard Wagner. And next, although produced many years after, we have another Liebig right here. And it's not on the description, but this is actually one of Ted Williams. We have graded this card before and wanted to show you guys. Next, we have a 54 Minoso Dixie Lids. It looks as though this could fit in a normal slab, but I believe with the lid part still on right here, as indicated by my thumb, I think it was just a little bit too big, and SGC wanted to be safe and put it in a bigger holder. And next, we're getting into some of our chocolate cards here. This one is of Archduke Francis Ferdinand, which his assassination started a world war. And we also have Teddy Roosevelt. And then this last card here is a variation of the Archduke Ferdinand, but this time it's in color. As you can see, when we compare these two cards, one is more black and white as opposed to the other one, which has some nice color to it. In this next batch of cards, we're going to go over 2 sets, the first of which being the Old Mill cards, the T210 set. This set contains an infamous Shoeless Joe Jackson card that is worth a lot of money, as well as a Cassie Stengel's first card as well. Unfortunately, we don't have those, but we do have some others to show you. It's the T210 Coleman. Also have the Kimbrough. Another Coleman, this time in a 3. The Heru, I think is how you say it, but I might be off on the pronunciation there. Horn. And the Gaustry. All right, so we just did that set. Now we're going to do another one that we picked up. Very cool. These are the 1947 Sports Exchange cards. They were hand cut, as you can see by the border and the label up here that says it's hand cut. And this card here specifically is considered one of Warren Spahn's rookie cards, and it was produced before the Leaf set. So here's the Warren Spahn. And then another cool rookie from the set is the Ralph Kiner. But in addition to that, we have Phil Rizzuto, Lou Boudreau, Hal Newhouser, Jimmy Fox, and the Bob Feller. Have a few more batches to go through. To start off, we have a Tony Perez rookie cup, except one problem here. It was labeled tops, as you can see. But if we turn to the back, it does say produced in Canada. So this is an Opeachy version, and it just happened to get mislabbed. We will definitely be including this in our next submission and seeing if they can hopefully correct it. Moving on, we have Charles Darwin from the Ogden set. The Dodgers big 3 and a 5. I also talk about this a lot, but I really did not think this card would get a 5 because, you know, you could see the edges even right there. But this set had a lot of edge wear problems. So they take that into account when grading these cards and end up pulling a 5. Next, we have the Nikola Tesla card. Pretty cool. Cecchini President Grant. There was also some other Cecchini baseball cards as well, but they did have some non-sports in there. Major Taylor. Felix Potent graded this card before. One of our highest grades that we've gotten so far on that. Pee Wee Reese. Forgot to include this with the Sports Exchange one, but this is another one from that set. 58 Tops All-Star Hank Aaron. Kit Carson from the Gaudi Indian Gum. Really nice colors on this set. George Stevenson from the Lone Jack Inventors set. A Bob Feller color added. I actually do not know where the color was added on this card. Sometimes with the wood ones, it can be hard to tell. And a Joe Tinker polar bear back. As you can see, it says polar bear on the back. A William McCovey. I had this raw and submitted it to grading, and I really didn't know. Like, I thought it was going to get an A, so really happy with the one there. And also had a Joe Morgan, which also got the one. Next, we have the Frank Gotch. Ray Robinson on the 48 Tops photos. Very small cards. Another 58 Tops Willie Mays. Have a Bowman, Phil Rizzuto. Decent grade on that. 64 Tops, Ernie Banks. 65 Tops, Lou Brock. A Jack Johnson, Hassan card. There's also another variation of this card in blue. Well, not another variation, a different card, but it's in the same set. The E75 Jack Johnson American Carmel. 1980 Tops Ricky Henderson rookie. A rookie cup of Ron Santo. 1961 Tops Willie McCovey. 1961 Fleer Lou Gehrig. And to end this stack off, an All-Star Willie McCovey. All right, last group coming in here for you guys. Ready or not, here we come. To start it off, we have a gold refractor of Willie Mays. I think it's one of Ryan's dollar box pickups. Ended up pulling a 9.5 on there. Next, another 9.5. This one of an old school Barry Bonds refractor. Another refractor from Barry Bonds. This one a little bit later from 2003, Topps Finest. And a David Ortiz, known then as David Arias, Wave of the Future card. Got the 9.5 on there as well. So did pretty decent with the modern cards. Moving right along. Have 65 Topps Carl Yastrzemski. 1951 Bowman Jackie Jensen. 65 Tops Frank Robinson. 1961 Tops Gehrig. I think this was our highest graded vintage card. I didn't even expect this to pull a 7 when I got it, but really awesome there. Catfish Hunter rookie, 3.5. Did have a crease down there. I don't know if you could see it. I did not think this was going to pull a 3.5, so definitely happy with this grade. Rolling Stones Cantini card. 1967 Topps Carl Yastrzemski. And the final card, a 1954 Mays. Really nice looking card here. I actually thought it would get a little bit more than a 3.5, but not a terrible grade. And a great card to end us off today. Alrighty, guys. Thank you all for tuning in as always. And we hope to see you around in the next sub.